Good morning. My name is Alan Calhoun, and this is the Northampton Reuse Committee. Today's date is August 13th, 2015. Our first agenda item is approval of July minutes.
Does everyone need, anyone need copies? These were the minutes that Rose sent out a week or so ago, and then I sent out again a couple days ago.
Any comments?
Same thing.
Yeah.
Oh, the one thing that needs to be changed is the in attendance piece up above. That was from our June meeting. Ro hadn't put down who was here last week, so
I was not here.
Who was not here?
And I was not.
David was here.
No, Alan.
I think I was.
No, John. No, Diane. Who else was? Who was here? Mac, you weren't
here.
You were here.
I was here.
Peter. You were here.
I'm pretty sure.
Debbie was here.
Yes.
What about you, Roger?
I was here.
You were here.
Oh,
okay.
But Deb, your name's there.
Okay. So no, Alan, John, or Diana. Last. Okay, I will make that edit.
With those corrections, motion to approve the minutes?
Move to approve.
We're good?
Second,
third.
Mm. So moved. Okay, the Reuse Center update agenda items, operations. Who would like to speak to that?
Should you speak or Diana, since Mac was not around lately?
Well, I will speak, actually, since I was... the supervisor last Saturday's event, and they sent around a little email about that. We had a really successful weekend. It was both a lovely day, and we had lots of customers, and we saw a rather significant amount of material leave and a lot of stuff come in, which is interesting. So it was really a very successful day. And I think we've been very fortunate, knock on wood, not to have rain on Saturday morning.
That's for sure.
I get the feeling that there are more and more people in the area that are coming out there and learning about the facility, and always get positive comments, and so it's been very successful today. Any other comments about operations?
We are due to have another Salvation Army pickup, I think, next week, and I'm going to call them. I was out there yesterday, and I think there's a lot of bric-a-brac out there, and so I think it would be good to let them know that there is stuff if they want to come for it, and I'll make that phone call and be there Wednesday and box up some of that stuff for them. So
good. Moving on to the
Roger had
it. Okay. Well, I'm just wondering, you know, the Facebook page has a lot of nice posts of stuff that you have in there. Is that attracting people?
I think so. I mean, you put up a picture of an aquarium and somebody took an aquarium. I don't know if it was because of that.
Right. Well, and the office supply post got a lot of attention, and people came in for stuff, right?
Yeah. Very cool.
Yeah.
Did anybody come on Wednesday for the dividers?
No.
Did I come?
Yes.
Huh?
Yeah.
Yes?
Did come at precisely 12 o'clock, minutes of 12, you'd already left.
Oh, okay.
And some guy in a old 89 Toyota with a roof rack, and he said, oh, it'll just take me 2 minutes to put them on. And yeah, so Marcia going, no, took a lot of no's. And I don't know what he expected, but he'll, with one panel up there, he'll pull his roof rack off. So, I mean, he's seen, they had a lot of stuff up here.
Yeah, no, I told him they were huge and 10 feet long.
Very strange fellow.
How much do you estimate that they weigh, Alan? Each one is like
250.
Each one is 250 pounds?
Wow. 200.
At least a couple hundred.
A couple of people.
And they are 10 by 4.
Yeah. So you might want to...
particle board.
Anna said that there was yet another person interested in them.
Yep.
And so you might want to make sure that he understands, or she, that they're 250 pounds each.
Are they damaged from the rain that we had?
The front one might be.
They're covered with vinyl, you know, so the water's really not.
Well, it's press board, press whatever the particle board underneath, so if that gets.
I don't think we want them out there much longer.
No.
The top one was starting. I noticed was starting to have little teeny bubbles.
Okay.
So
So I'll check with this person and see if he wants to come back. Did he seem like he wanted to come back?
He really was kind of out there, spaceball kind of. So, yeah, he was just very unhappy. Couldn't take him then.
Oh. I'll check with them and then.
Yeah, but I don't think it's a good idea for his car. One way or another.
Okay.
No? Is the Reed Center open Wednesday now?
No, it's just that there's several of us have been out there working in the facility, and occasionally we have people come by for specific items.
Okay.
For example, in Salvation Army Con.
Right, that I knew. But this is just
we're not open.
Showed up.
No.
We're not open. Someone shows up.
And just a comment, there's been a little bit of confusion about that, because sometimes people come in and start looking around and shopping, and we've got a kind of, I think those of us that are there need to put some boundaries around that, although the other side is you're trying to educate people and encourage them to enjoy the place, but at the same time, we're not really set up for...
Yeah.
Why don't
we tell them 5 minutes? We can give them a couple of minutes
and
then just, sorry, we have to get back to work.
I think we can say, today is a work day.
Yeah.
You know, Wednesdays are work days,
yeah.
And you're welcome to come and look for a few minutes, but we can't, you know...
Yeah.
Do you think that would work, Alan?
I think it will.
Yeah,
I think that's fine.
You're welcome to help out.
Yes.
Yeah, if you
want
to volunteer.
Okay.
Yeah. Physical site. Peter, you've been working in the rain.
Yeah, I'm going to have those shelves finished by Christmas.
There was a
wasp nest in the Salvation Army box. At one point, I think that it has been taken care of, but the last time the Salvation Army guy came on a Saturday, he got stung. So
I saw him with a spray can. Did he?
Okay.
Was he maybe either the gatekeepers gave him a spray can, or he?
I think it was taken care of. I just wanted to make note about it.
Thank you very much.
I put some things in the box yesterday, and I had been stung a few weeks ago, and I didn't notice any wasp activity there at this point. And if the box was unloaded, and I didn't notice or hear of any distress from over that way.
Okay.
So a couple of things we have talked about for operations, in addition to shelving in the ramp room, after the season is over, we'll probably want to replace the door from recenter going into the ramp room, because it's a narrow, short door.
Right.
Several of us have thought that some space in the ramp room might become useful for part of the shop, because we're kind of crowded in the shop, and we could designate a section of that for displaying items. And the other possibility of using some or all that space for storing seasonal items. We've gotten a lot of Christmas stuff, for example, in the summer, and I can imagine in the fall we're going to get a lot of summer stuff for the following spring, so we may want to think about having a place to keep some of these things. The other issues that we're going to have to deal with, one is lighting. That ramp room has one light bulb in it. It really is not well lit. If we do have public coming into there, we'd have to have better lighting. The annex area, the electrician was kind enough to put up one spotlight, but it's insufficient lighting for that area to really have the public come through there. And then we're going to have to decide how best to use the space. We've been storing some lumber scraps and larger items and furniture stuff, which I think is fine, although partly because the place has been disorganized and partly because we don't have proper lighting. We haven't had a lot of public in there yet to even see what's available. And if we want to turn stuff over, we're going to have to shake that place up and clean it up a bit.
We haven't advertised lumber at all
because
of that.
I don't think that, without the lighting, I don't think we can let public
in
there.
We've had occasional people come through. There's a gentleman that likes certain scraps of wood for his own.
But only chaperoned, right?
Only
like, chaperoned. We don't let public in there.
I had a lady looking for sheathing for project she was doing at home, so I went in with her and picked out a few pieces for her.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I try to pull things out when I'm there on Saturday mornings, try to pull things out of there to display out front.
Right.
The door guy goes there unattended. I've seen him. He's, you know, he goes. He just goes to look and see, you know. And so we need to decide whether we want to say something to him or not.
If I'm there, I go in with him.
Okay.
Actually,
I saw him go in, and I would yeah.
Who's the door guy? What does that?
Well, he's been picking up stuff there long before we existed because they used to save doors for him.
Okay.
He takes the, which is really great. I mean, he takes the old wooden doors and he uses them to build furniture. Actually, he reuses them.
There is still a leak from the roof, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Where is that, Peter?
Well, as you come into the addenda space from the ramp room, it's kind of directly to the left.
Mm-hmm.
There's a big wet spot there.
Okay. The I have approval from the Department of Environmental Protection to purchase a tent.
Oh.
So it's just a matter of figuring out where to, do we get one online? Do we try to find one locally? If somebody wants to help out with that project, we could potentially have it for Saturday. But Ned is out this week. So I don't think it's a problem because I just can talk to BJ. But
what's the budget on that?
I'm sorry?
The budget on that? How much, how much do we have for that?
Well, Anna, do you remember how much they cost when we looked? Deb and I looked. Deb and I looked. They're a couple hundred.
I think so.
Yeah.
I don't really know.
Yeah.
They come down a lot.
You get used to.
Now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The end
they're
of the
on
season.
Sale,
yeah.
The end of the season.
I bought
yeah.
one
yeah.
for $100.
We want to get an Easy Up brand because that's the brand that the professional artists and stuff, you know, people who do shows and stuff use, and they're very durable and very simple to use.
We want just a campy or one with walls.
Camping.
Yeah. Okay. Moving on, volunteers.
Volunteers. I spoke with David a little bit about this, and I don't have my notes with me, I don't think, but we talked about the need to have perhaps some more, what are we calling them, volunteers in charge.
Supervisors
in charge, volunteer supervisors. Just a few more, and to have a pool of, I'm sorry, I should have pulled that out, a pool of a certain number of volunteers.
Five, I think. So that
right, no, but I mean regular volunteers,
see,
a pool of regular volunteers as well. Yeah, so we thought about five supervisors, and that way people could rotate and just do one a month,
mm-hmm.
And then to have a pool of volunteers. And so one of the things that, there are two things that I would like to ask you, and one is, what types of things do you think somebody needs to be aware of before they volunteer, before they become a volunteer officially? And secondly, what things are you doing out there that you're doing because you think they need to be done and not because you've been asked to do them? I'd like to capture those things because those things operationally are things that we have to make sure, potentially, are things that we want to make sure get done. So, for instance, Mac is going out. Oh, Diane, Debbie was out there, and she's been organizing the art room and sometimes working on labels and labeling things and cleaning up on Wednesdays. Those are things that we want to just capture
yeah.
what kind of work
list.
Is being done. If somebody's going into the lumber room and organizing, you know, once we've captured all those tasks that really should be done, we can work out a system to make sure they get done regularly, whether you're there or not. So I just want to put that out there. But the more to point issue is, what things do you think a volunteer should know in order to be representing the recenter and the committee out there?
Susan, do you want to do this now, or is this a
request? I thought just a couple minutes popcorn would be appropriate, and if people have a lot, you know, if nobody can come up with anything, or we have a lot, we can take it offline. But does anyone have what comes to mind?
Well, yesterday someone came in and Mac said, I think, well, how about she was a volunteer who comes in anyway, and so she swept the floor, and that was great.
Uh-huh.
I mean,
I don't know the
right.
I don't know the last time somebody swept the floor. That was great. That
but,
was good.
But what kinds of things do you think that volunteers should know about or
oh,
know
no.
how to do before they
oh, I thought you
before
meant
they're officially a volunteer?
Okay.
No.
I thought I was on a different subject.
Well, either knowing how to do something, A,
yeah.
or I mean, do we or how to do something or about the process and the system and the
okay,
center.
Not the extra jobs.
Yeah.
That was one of the things that we did.
Yeah.
Well, one of the things would be knowing how to training, what to tell the other volunteers
mm-hmm.
who aren't, you know, volunteer leaders
mm-hmm.
that everyone calls. So that they're going to have to know those things because there'll be questions.
Right, the volunteer leader, but as just a general volunteer,
right.
what things?
Well, checking in, checking out.
Right.
They need to know that process and
mm-hmm.
where to put things.
Mm-hmm.
We have, the overview.
Right. Yeah. No. I mean, I just wanted to see if there were other things. Now that we've been around for 10 weeks or something like that, or if nobody's coming up with anything, that's fine. I just thought I would put it out to the group.
What happens if there's a task? You know,
mm-hmm.
one of the other volunteers or a ship supervisor will
mm-hmm.
say, "How about?"
Mm-hmm.
helping out with such and such.
Okay.
And it's really
okay.
just a question of it,
yeah.
being willing to accept the fact that there are some tasks that we're going to
right.
come up. And
okay.
Is there a checklist of things you have to do before you open and when you
yes.
close?
Yes, we have that already enumerated.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. Well, we don't have to spend any more time. I just thought
I would
put the
yeah.
question to you.
So, getting back to shift supervisors,
mm-hmm.
I think the three of us who have been doing it would welcome other shift supervisors. John or Roger or anybody that wants to help sometime.
And I would like to have a shift supervisor meeting to talk about issues and lessons learned and stuff like that. So in the next couple weeks, probably next, the week after next probably. I'm going to be out next week. So the week after next, if we can maybe...
I will be away that week.
Oh, will you? Bummer. Okay, well, then it's not going to happen that week either. Well, so I'll, you know what, I'll do a doodle. The question is, of the shift supervisors who are here, do you prefer an afternoon, day, morning, evening?
Morning.
Okay, morning.
Okay. And we have a subcommittee meeting next week, don't we?
Right.
The 18th?
Are you
yeah, I won't be there.
You won't be there.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
You guys
but
can go ahead and meet.
But we can brainstorm
yep.
a list of
all right. Very good.
Concerns and questions and whatnot.
So,
great.
We did have a new volunteer out there last week, by the way, who had been someone who came and just was so enthused about it. She volunteered and did a great job.
Is that Sally?
Sally.
Oh, good.
Yeah, I'm confident that other people are going to emerge. I just think we're every now and then going to get people like that don't know about us yet that come out and say, this really fits with what I want to do as a volunteer.
We also have a pretty extensive list of people who have signed releases, and I'm going to do some outreach to see if they are interested in coming. A number of people, there's an Ally and a, who's the woman that
Lola?
Came out?
Or
no, but anyway, there are a few, and so I'm going to call them to see if they have any interest. If they don't, we can just make sure that
okay.
they're not considered.
Let's move on. Intern report.
Would there be like a handyman supervisor for people who are going to do kind of mechanical repairs to the place?
Good thought. I don't know. Really
that would be you, Roger.
We've got a couple of people. There was a gentleman who wanted to do electronic repairs, although we haven't had any electronics to repair.
That we know of.
Everybody says the stuff they bring out works, but sometimes hard to tell. But there are, you know, I don't know whether we can get a list of people who volunteer who have special interests of things.
And special skills.
Special skills.
Not even who volunteer, but who come and have special skills.
Right.
And
yeah.
I've been trying to. Max started a little stack of index cards to that, and I have added to that one. I added one.
Mm-hmm. I mean, with the electronics, if we had someone that wanted to do that, it would be great to have them come on a Wednesday and just test stuff on Wednesday.
That's a good idea.
Yesterday, these people were interested in these shredders that we had three shredders and we tested them and none of them worked. I mean, or they partially worked. So out they went. But, you know, we have a lot of stuff around that could use testing and someone could put a little label on it. And
he told me he was going to show up and then he didn't show up. So.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Right.
Was it just electronics or electric
cars on?
Appliances,
like
a saw.
Everything could be tested.
Because you could plug in, I guess.
Yeah, now remember when we first were conceiving this idea, we thought that we would have people show us how it worked.
We were going to test everything as it came in. It's impractical.
Is it impractical?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, sometimes
completely.
It's impractical, and sometimes, you know, if you get an amplifier, but you don't have speakers to hook it to, how do you know, right? Or you get a DVD player and you don't have a TV to plug it into.
So one thing we can do is try to grill them a little bit more on, you know, if you look people in the eye and say, does it work well? You can see if they shudder their eyes. You know what I mean? You
right.
just really look them right in the face.
Or we recycle it
yeah.
if it doesn't work. Because
right.
people do take
right.
things that sort of work and fix
right.
them.
Mm-hmm.
And
right.
I'm not interested in grilling people.
Well, it's not really grilling. I'm exaggerating.
Okay.
But we also said in the past, ask, is this something you would give your best friend?
Right.
Does it work well enough to give it to your best friend? You know, I mean, just a couple of simple questions. I'm sorry, Mac, I interrupted you.
Well, I was going to say the other part of it with something like these paper shredders was people may not be aware that it's not going to
mm-hmm.
cost them anything to dispose of those because the lower half is
uh-huh.
rigid plastic and the upper half has a motor, so it goes in the metal. So somebody may be thinking, well, I don't really want to pay a fee on this, and it sort of works, so
mm-hmm.
maybe they want it. But if we just say, you know, if we say to them, you know, we're really interested in if it's in really good condition. If not, it is recyclable, you know, and you don't have to pay a fee on it. And then that may, in some cases, spare the whole, you know, us taking in something that's marginal, and then it can just go on to its next lifetime.
Sure.
Regarding your investigation a little further with people in the trade, the thing, look for the apologies first.
Mm-hmm.
So you ask them, does it work? You know, in other words, ask them maybe twice, are all the parts working? You know, oh, no, it doesn't go into reverse or whatever. You know. So that's like a follow-up question maybe is worthwhile.
Uh-huh.
Does it work? You know, do all the parts work?
Uh-huh.
Not just
work every day of the week.
But only on Sundays when it's raining.
Only
Saturday
at 10 o'clock, yeah.
Unless anybody else, do you have something else?
Could you have a testing station? You just bring it up, put it on the table, and here are the speakers, and here's the amplifier
that
you plug it into.
Absolutely.
We can develop that.
And
yeah.
in the office,
mm-hmm.
we have a work table on the space. I actually showed
mm-hmm.
this.
Yeah.
Electronic repairman in the space, and he said, oh, this is great, this will work.
Right. Mm-hmm. But when people bring stuff in, a table that outside or
mm-hmm.
inside that they could go to and say, does this work?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't know. Okay, we'll plug it in.
Yeah,
see
we do
if it, works.
We do, and sometimes we should perhaps make it more formal, right at the intake table, have a plug out there. We could probably take an extension cord. But sometimes what we do is we take it and plug it in to one of the outlets in the facility itself
right
away. But sometimes the things, again, if you have to hook it up to a monitor, for example,
right.
it just takes too much time.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Well,
right.
the other challenge is that as volunteers, I don't want people messing around with electricity and risking. If somebody has something that was sat out in the rain and then they brought it to us and we plug it in, it's an area that I don't want to get into too much. Even having somebody come and fix it, we need to be careful about if it's a professional or something. It's something that I just want to make sure that the city is aware of is happening. Mm. So there's a little bit of, I'm sorry, I was thinking of something else and it blew out of my mind. I apologize.
I have two thoughts. One is, if we're going to say no, or when we're going to say no, to make sure we know where that can go, because a lot of that stuff can go somewhere. It doesn't just have to go, you know, out the window. And also, what, I think it's Rich you're talking about, the man who repairs, or who fixes electronics. He probably does other things too. We can find out from him what he does repair.
And any of his buddies.
Any other thoughts?
There's also sort of a category of things like I found several vacuum cleaners out there, you know, and you plug them in. Yes, the motor works, but it's like very gentle suction. You know, it's really not going to get very much, and that's probably why it ended up there. So, with something like a vacuum cleaner, I'm likely to question. I mean, why would someone get rid of a vacuum cleaner that's in perfectly working condition unless they're mother-in-law dropped dead or something. But, so anyway, there's that too. There's that, you know, kind of, yes, it works, but...
Yeah, right.
Also the wet canine slobber that comes when you turn it on.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
I'm going to assign the taskmaster, I'm going to move on.
So I've been continuing to work on the who takes what. I spoke with a technology savvy friend of mine yesterday, and she thought that my plan for making it accessible online seems doable and pretty straightforward. If we just have to go through the city, the person who manages the website. So if anyone's out there at the recenter and notices things that we can't take, that we need to find a place for, let me know, because I'm still working on that. And then I'm also planning a compost educational display for the recenter, maybe near the grassy area.
I wanted to ask you about the Craigslist issue, because I thought it was a great idea when things come along. And is this something we can do? You were doing this on your private account. Is there a possibility of having a recenter account with, is it okay for publicly to do this with Craigslist?
I don't know who in the city would need to approve that.
Yeah, I will talk to Ned.
But it is something that reuse organizations use. My friend's mom used to work for Reuse Hawaii, which is like an eco-building bargains type of place. And Eco-Building Bargains uses Craigslist.
Mm-hmm.
So organizations do have accounts. And the thing I want to figure out, and I think you can use Craigslist for this, is so far the things I've posted on Craigslist, I see a record of them. So even though I've taken the dividers off of Craigslist and other people can't see them, I can still see that I posted it on this date.
Wow.
And so I was like, maybe this could be part of the record-keeping system. If it will stay on Craigslist, and I don't know how long it stays there, but if it would stay there, that might function as a
That's really an excellent tool.
Yeah, it was amazing. I was amazed. The four people right away called me. I really want the dividers.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody, it seems like a whole other audience of people.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Like the man I spoke with, he said he checks Craigslist every day, and that everything in his house is from Craigslist.
Wow.
Yeah. Including his car.
The only thing with Craigslist is that technically the city, you know, when the city casts off stuff, there's a very regimented kind of process that needs to happen, as Debbie can attest to with her yellow filing cabinet. So I will check into it. There's a little tiptoeing around, but I think we can probably do it. If it's stuff that has come in through the recenter, it shouldn't be a problem.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, there it's just another outlet. I mean, Facebook has a limited audience.
Yeah.
And if people are checking Craigslist, this may be another place for stuff.
Yeah, absolutely.
Free.
So, question for Anna. Is this stuff that we've already got in, or stuff that we couldn't take in because it wasn't appropriate?
For the Craigslist?
Yeah. Well,
I've only posted the dividers.
So far.
From the recenter.
Right. And do you see it going forward just as stuff we've taken in, or which is logical?
Oh, yeah, I would think that.
Yeah. Because eventually, with something like that, somebody could post their own.
Right, they would have to post their own.
Mm-hmm.
Post their own
stuff.
Right,
kind of like a bulletin board.
Yeah.
Right. We were hoping to have a digital bulletin board one day.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
At some point.
You also had the catalog idea. Is that part of it? Is this part of it, or is that
the catalog is the who takes what thing, and that I'm hoping to put on the city's website. And then I'm thinking about the idea of making it physical, because it seems like something that's much better suited to digital. But I might be able to make it a physical thing with cards. But then we'd have to update it. It'd be harder to update.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
And Anna, when is your last day?
Oh, right. I'm leaving. I have 2 more weeks. I'm going back to school for the 29th. So yeah.
when do you think you'll be finished?
Be done here in 2 weeks, so probably like the 27th.
But since we won't have another general meeting, let me just...
Yes, it's been enjoyable, sir.
Yes,
thank you for
appreciate
welcoming
it.
Me into the group.
Yeah.
He's been great.
Yeah.
We're going to miss you.
I'll miss you guys.
Right. Or you can come back and visit us on vacation.
Yes. I know where to find you.
At the risk of putting you on the spot, what is the biggest thing that you're taking away from this experience? You don't have to answer.
On the spot, I'll tell you what it says on the spot is.
Okay.
First of all, how to, because I joined a group last year at college, and it kind of seemed like kind of a group that's struggling to function well. And so the first thing was just observing this group. I think I've learned a lot just by sitting here and like watching you guys talk and see how you actually manage to do things and be productive. And another thing is just how much work it takes to accomplish relatively little things.
Amen to that.
But to do them well.
Right. I think they're valuable.
You can do anything quickly, but you don't care.
Right. Yeah.
The group process slows things down, but you end up with a better product.
Very good. Silent auction.
Silent auction. I brought that topic up because we have been setting things aside for a potential silent auction, and we haven't officially decided we're going to have a silent auction and when. So I wanted to spend a few minutes talking about, is this going to happen this year? Is this something we should put off until next year and not worry about this year? What are your thoughts? This is prompted because, in part, one of our very good volunteers was interested in something that was set aside for the silent auction. And I said that it should not be taken because it had until this group decides what's going to happen to the silent auction. Because if we start cherry-picking stuff away from the silent auction, there's no point in having a silent auction. On the other hand, you know, the volunteer might have been willing to give money, you know, so then you have to... A silent auction, the whole point of it is you try to get the most you can. So how do you assign a value to something that somebody wants? And, you know, it was just an awkward situation. I wanted to see what the group thought about, A, are we having a silent auction, and B, if so, what are the rules?
Well, I don't know about silent or loud, but for the toy auction, we have the offer from the auctioneer already. Who does his auctions out there to have an actual toy auction live.
Right. But that wasn't, yeah. So the question is, silent auction for the recenter, were we to do it, when would we do it?
And it's okay if we do that, raising money for wherever the money would go?
Yeah, it would go into our
fund.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So we can do it. We're allowed to do it.
I will triple check, but I've spoken about the silent auction to Ned, and he was okay with the concept, I believe.
Could we include the things that were set aside in the... Are you suggesting that there's a December toy auction? Could we include the things that we've set aside
That's a good idea.
I like the idea of combining it with some other event, because then it was like an auction to a single event. Might not get a lot of people.
Right.
But it's a different population,
audience.
Isn't it?
Right.
Okay. A different audience, I would think.
It is, but at the same time, it's a large audience.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the toy event attracts lots and lots of people. And it's a time when people are looking for gifts.
And re-gifting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but it's not necessarily... The stuff we get in isn't necessarily something you'd give as a gift. I mean, in this one particular case,
culture.
It is, but in our current culture.
I'm not quite sure. You've been looking at this, Mac. How much stuff
there's not a really large quantity. I'd say there's, at this point, maybe 10 items or something like that we've set aside.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a large quantity.
Well, something to consider is that something like this takes a lot of work. We have 4 events coming up in the fall. To do something like this, organize it, publicize it. It's an investment of time. We also need to think about what if we do it once, are we going to do it annually? Is this going to be an annual thing? If so, what time of year makes the most sense to do it? Mm-hmm. Those are questions that.
Mm-hmm. I can see
I was going to say, I'm just looking at what we have coming up. Mm-hmm. It's obviously too much to do it in September.
Mm-hmm.
Toy exchange doesn't sound like it's going to work. So we only have two events, the tag sale and the rally.
Mm-hmm.
Tag sale, are we going to be doing
it? It's costume swap and tag sale.
Yeah, so that becomes, it's a lot of people. We get a lot of, but we also have to have a place to put everything. It'd be good because it's ongoing.
Yeah.
It's a long period of time.
Yeah.
And then you can have a big announcement at the end. So that's a possibility. But
yeah, it is a possibility.
Yeah.
If it's fair weather, we could have we could have it staffed and just have a couple spaces. Of, but it's harder to do a silent auction. Usually silent auctions are kind of a captive audience.
Yeah.
You have their information and their. On the other hand, if you just have people put their phone numbers, if the person who made the biggest bid ends up not showing up, you can just call the person who had the highest bid.
And what's the rally? What's the rally?
The rally is our recycling and reuse rally with bulky rigid plastic and styrofoam and bikes.
Silent auctions to me are, at least the way I've seen them, is that there's a captive audience where you continue to go back and look until the time runs out, the highest bid wins.
Yeah.
None of those are places where people will come and stick around.
Yeah.
So you put a bid in early and you leave, you're not going to win.
Mm.
People aren't going to come back and rebid. So I think you just come at the end and you're the last person who bids and you win. It doesn't fit, at least the way I understand silent auctions.
Uh-huh.
You really want to cap the audience, so we don't have that.
Right.
So people can
right.
see other people's
right.
bids.
Mm. That's how you know the
yes.
size.
Right. Right.
To ask people to make a bid, that's weird. I mean,
how about a webpage rebid?
Oh.
We have an auction online.
Oh, that you could do an online auction.
That's
you could.
Yeah, that would be.
They do them. It's a lot of work, but.
One of the questions you're asking,
Your Honor.
Yeah. Listen, is the work worth the amount of money we think we're going to raise from a dozen items?
We'll never know until we do it.
Yeah.
Well,
right.
Well, around Thanksgiving time, if it were online. People could come and see the items, and it'd be like for two weekends in a row or something, and then the actual event would happen. So they could be there for that second, you know, it would be Saturday at 11 or something, we'd pick however that would work. You know,
so we would maybe set up a little corner of the recenter for
display
for a couple of sessions and let people see the stuff. And
you know, up top they can see things that are coming up for the Thanksgiving.
Well, so part of that, I love the idea of having the display, having things visible for people to see beforehand. The problem is some of them can walk off. So we have some toy things, for instance, that are like really hot items. And so that means you kind of need somebody there to kind of hang out and I mean, it introduces a whole set of challenges. And I'm one, so I... The first question is this something that we want to pursue this year? And if it's not, some of those items that we've set aside probably aren't going to be good to keep around for 12 months or 8 months in that space because they, first of all, the toys are going to get older and people are going to lose interest in them. The furniture, you know, that might not be a good place to store. So those are the issues. So the first question is, can we have one this year? Thank you, Dad.
I see it in relation with the tag sale the easiest. So we have 12 items. We have our own booth. And that's the easiest. And just bring it over in a van, my van.
Well, it's better than, I mean, I agree with John. It's not ideal, but if we could get something for the stuff, it's better than nothing, even if it pays for one advertisement for the toy set swap or toy exchange.
Well, another option if we want to keep it really simple might be instead of having an auction, would just be to say, to get somebody to advise us, like an antiques expert or whatever,
mm-hmm.
on what would be a reasonable price to ask for something, and then just put a price on it and say, for a such and such donation to the Rees Center, take it away.
Yeah.
You know, and then
there
you don't
you
have
go.
An auction.
Sell them.
That makes more sense.
Uh-huh. I mean, if uh-huh. we just sell it, basically, instead
it.
Of doing
yeah.
the auction thing. It's so much simpler, you know.
Right.
And then that fits into the tag sale as well.
Right.
You know,
mm-hmm.
Having
yeah.
a separate booth for that. At the
right.
That's
right.
a great idea, Mac. And
that's
then it's an instant, it would be a lot easier than any kind of an auction. Do you guys want to pursue that then?
Yep.
Thanks.
And then we could annually do it at the tag sale. Now, the next question is, if a volunteer is interested in something that has come in, what is the process that we can all support for handling that?
I guess it has to be valued. I mean, we'll
yeah.
have to have the appraiser to say what it's worth, and then, I don't know, does the volunteer get first dibs if they want to pay that price? I don't know.
I don't see what the difference would be. I mean, we want the money. It doesn't matter
yeah.
who gets it.
Yeah.
The volunteer buys it. What's the difference?
Well, they get first crack at it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
yeah.
Just like they get first crack at anything new.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Right. Right. So if they want to pay the price.
So they don't have to wait until the tag sale. If we have
right.
if we have an independent person place a value on it,
yeah.
they can just make a donation of that amount.
Yeah.
What's the difference?
Is that Is the committee
mm-hmm.
okay with that? Should we
mm-hmm.
have a vote with that?
Mm-hmm.
I mean this is a volunteer who's been really terrific, and I don't mm-hmm. want to have annoyed him. I just wanted to have a process in place that's
yeah.
fair.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's vote.
Sure.
Vote, Alan. Can you?
All those in favor?
Aye.
Anyone opposed?
Excellent.
For the record.
Okay.
Another
appraiser.
Mm.
We just
right,
need
the appraiser.
Right, and another simple way, and you can't do this with everything, but if it's something that is likely to have been sold on something like eBay,
mm.
you know, you can go there and look at their completed listings and see what it's been selling
yes.
for on eBay,
mm-hmm.
just to give you a ballpark figure, you know,
mm-hmm.
what it's worth
yeah.
out there.
Mm-hmm.
Time's moving on. So,
okay. Thank you.
Teacher Day.
Teacher Day. So, with the donation of school supplies that I had, and in talking briefly with Barbara Black about it, it occurred to me that teachers might really want to know about our facility, and that when they come to back to school and start setting things up is a good time to get their attention about it. So, it might be a neat idea to send out a flyer inviting them to come out to the Rees Center, perhaps giving them a pass to come once without a sticker,
mm-hmm.
and letting them know, you know, what types of things that we have in art room and stuff like that. So I wanted to see how you guys felt about that. It would have to happen pretty quickly because they're starting to gear up.
Mm.
What are your thoughts?
A Wednesday would be, maybe?
A Wednesday is a possibility,
mm.
yeah.
That'd be easier.
I'm all in favor of getting as many people out there
mm-hmm.
as possible.
Okay.
I think we're so remote, the site
mm-hmm.
is so remote that
mm-hmm.
driving people in there is
great. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Anyone have any concerns about that? Or
I would. Go ahead.
It's not exactly a concern, but because of that event that Mac and I did a few years ago with Costume Plus Art Materials,
mm-hmm.
where we got so much, it was
mm-hmm.
just like. And it was amazing. It wasn't just strictly art materials. I mean, it was normal art materials and
mm-hmm.
also unusual.
Mm-hmm.
To shout out to our Facebook or wherever we do that we're collecting this stuff too for
mm-hmm.
teachers. This is
mm-hmm.
what we're looking for, so that we have more stuff. We have some paper. We have some crayons. So it's nothing like the collection that we had that day. Not that I'm not necessarily looking for that. That was a terrific event. It brought out a lot of stuff that was in people's closets.
Mm-hmm.
There's probably
mm-hmm.
still a lot. And that's the kind of stuff, at least some of it, is what teachers
sure.
can use.
Well, somebody, when I was talking about it with somebody, I don't remember who, they suggested that we could have a a bulletin board or a sheet of paper that teachers could write down the kinds of things they'd be interested in getting.
Yes.
You know, so not that we promise it, but if you will take these things and these are things you want, we can communicate that to our audience.
Yes, I wish.
So do you think a Wednesday, I'm sorry, Roger, do you have something to add?
Well, I was just thinking it's bringing up a much larger marketing possibility. We have toy exchange, it's going great. Uh-huh. Teacher Day is something. Contractor Day. I mean, you could have all kinds of different ideas for people that need different types of goods.
What were the other ideas you said? You said Contractor Day and what else?
I don't. I haven't thought of any. The storm is still forming.
Athlete's Day.
Pep Day.
If you're going to do this on a Wednesday, though, you're going to
So you'd have a build-up to it. Yeah. You'd ask for, you put out a general request for these kind of materials for that specific
student day.
So I'm sorry, Alan was going
to
say something.
I was just going to say, if we're going to do it on Wednesday, we need to get organized with enough people to staff in place to do that.
And you're talking about next week or the week after.
Right.
The school starts.
Well, so maybe we just send out a flyer inviting them, telling them about it this year, and then maybe think about it for next year.
We could put a Facebook post saying if you have things that teachers might use, bring them in before September. August.
And to save time and money, I wouldn't even bother a flyer. I would just somehow get it through the superintendent or Barbara Black's office and have it electronically to all the teachers in the school system.
Okay.
And maybe there's a connection to the private schools, the campus school.
Then you'd have to come up with some mechanism to give them a free pass.
I'll tell a friend of mine who works at campus school.
Yeah. Maybe if they, we can send them a PDF electronically, and if they print it out and bring it, it'll have something they can show the gatekeeper or something.
Right,
But, yeah, okay.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Do we want to go outside and camp too?
Not this year.
Okay. Well, we don't have all that many teacher materials.
Would we be asking them to kind of limit themselves to things that they're going to use in their classrooms, or just say whatever? I mean, it would be hard to...
We want to advertise the place, so if...
I say whatever.
Yeah.
I say whatever, as long as they understand that the sharing, the sharing value that we have.
I would take a door and say,
not
this is my classroom. What are you going to say?
We're going to make a work of art on the door.
These kids are adorable.
Okay, so next on the agenda, just an event update review of 9/12. Are we going to be doing that?
Yeah, we're going to have some demos of repairs, and we're going to have some examples of things that have been rehabbed.
Excellent.
Nice.
See? Mm-hmm. Here are the flyers.
Oh,
suddenly.
Are we in the afternoon? Or are we in?
We're in the afternoon.
We are in the afternoon.
Yes.
Okay.
From noon to 3.
Sure.
Oh, great.
So Diana, if you could make a JPEG of something like this
You a JPEG?
Oh, you did send me a JPEG. Okay. Mm-hmm. Is there something that's
small
and can be posted on Facebook that's attention getting besides the whole thing is a JPEG? Something bright and, we can work on
it. I sent you this as a JPEG. So if that's not good, then I'll try something else, but I don't really have any time for it.
Okay.
So I'll
I will create something then. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, send it out. I'm going to post it at the Eastworks. On the bulletin board.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So it'd be nice to have bigger ones, colorful ones that we can we can post.
I made
We have them. If you want them, that's what she just handed you. So,
what's that?
Oh, did they go double sided? Visit Deb afterwards if you would like to have some made that you would like to post somewhere.
Sure.
So Diana, what other things do you need from the group?
If anybody has somebody that wants to do a demo of rehabbing or refinishing or whatever, any of our rewords for things that they've gotten and they're giving new life to, I think I'll talk to Lenny about the bags.
Yeah.
And did you have somebody that would do
it? She's going to do it. She is
going
to do it.
Yeah, I've got to just official it.
How about the door guy?
So how would the work... workshops, demos, would they start at a certain time? how we're going to... I need to tell Scott.
Anytime noon to 2, I think, they could start. They would set up their table and they would...
Well, maybe like 1 o'clock to make sure there's people there at that point.
Okay.
For them. Yeah. I had talked to Scott about doing it in the morning at 9 o'clock, you know, before it got too busy.
Yep.
He was good with that, but I haven't checked back with him until I knew for, sure that it was the afternoon.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Could you send out what things you're going to need for this? Like, we have plenty of tables we can find. Or
okay.
Carts.
Oh, that's
carts.
Great.
Okay. David, share about those ping pong tables out there that are...
And we have a lot of doors. If people bring sawhorses, we can
mm-hmm.
put doors on them, too.
Play ping pong on the doors.
Mm-hmm.
That would be interesting.
So one question is, do you guys think that we should bother having some kind of refreshments? I can talk to Ned, he's not in this week, but is this something, we talked about having like a playlist, having music, if somebody has a band or something that they know and they're willing to organize that piece, Diana would love to have you organize that piece, otherwise what?
Bake sale.
Hmm.
The high school, or whoever did it at the, you know, whoever does that.
The environmental club or something.
That'll
whoever
be tough on
was.
September 12th.
It might at least
it
be
would,
real
but
tough.
Maybe it'll work.
Mm-hmm. Couldn't hurt to try.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I would say, and I know Debbie, the band idea,
mm-hmm.
music.
Mm-hmm.
Let's not do that.
Mm-hmm.
That's too distracting.
Well, unless somebody
wants
to take it on,
yeah,
you know, but. Okay, so then we need to have some kind of a boombox and
we have
music.
We have CD player.
Okay.
I'm not worried about.
I wonder if the person that's apparently NAC has changed hands.
Uh-huh.
If the new person would be interested in bringing
her
to display.
I can ask her.
Okay.
Our office is right across from her.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It's changed hands.
Yeah.
The display. Some kind of just inspiration.
I contacted the Gazette and asked them if they would print a guest column in there,
mm-hmm.
and that would be just sort of a summation of our activities and also an invitation to this, and they said yes, and so 750 words, and they, you know, basically I'm going to start working on that, and then I'll send out the draft at some point, people
thank
can
you.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
So and try to get it in there a week before or something like that.
Great.
That's great.
Do you think we could do a monthly guest column? Just to
let's see how this.
Yeah, I don't know.
This goes.
I don't know.
What? How many words did you say?
750.
Okay.
This is for people.
Just to say what's going on at the Reese Center. Put out some of the information that comes out in posts, and just let that audience know about it.
They might be hesitant to. Do a monthly thing, but a periodic thing,
yeah.
You know, would
whatever
be
they were say.
Quarterly.
Okay,
tag sale,
yes.
October 10th.
Mm-hmm.
Are we having a tag sale?
Yes. And
you're looking at me.
Well, I've got to look at somebody.
Yeah.
With Roger and I will... it'll just be really the advertising is the part from the manager.
Okay. So we should have a meeting if we can make a meeting in early September,
sure.
Maybe, and just put our ducks on the table and figure or in a row or whatever.
Put them on the table, see if they'll get in a row.
And you're gonna hold it at the vocational school? Is that where you do this?
Mm-hmm.
You've done this in the past?
Yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. What the fourth one now? Third and fourth.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And this rally November 7th.
Yeah, I think it's the Bulky Ridge of Plastic, Styrofoam, and this year Bikes Not Bombs will join us.
Again, nice.
And it sounds like a fabulous group. I've been in touch with the person in Boston. The only issue the committee needs to know is that they expect $10 per bike. That's what they want.
Okay.
Because they
donation.
Spend money, a donation, because they take them the bikes and ship them around the world.
Oh.
And they just,
mm-hmm.
it costs them.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
They will not take a bike if you don't donate it, but that's what the expectation is, and they would like it on all the advertising that we are, that they're expecting $10. It's not us, we're
mm-hmm.
not going to take any money, but they
mm-hmm.
have they'll have a separate spot. I want to make sure that's okay with you. So people at least know ahead of time. If someone
mm-hmm.
says, I didn't bring any money, you know, and they get upset, then they'll take the bike. He said that rarely happens. People are willing to give money. In fact, they give more money. It's a good group.
That's nice.
Do they take bikes that aren't in repair?
Yes.
Yeah,
they'll
take anything.
They fix them.
They'll take a bike, they'll fix
parts,
them.
Spare parts.
They take parts,
oh,
yeah.
Gotcha.
Doesn't matter if the thing's bent or
did
the wheel's
you look
broken.
Into bikes some more? Was that?
Well, we found the Hubs person, the Holyoke YMCA Urban Bike Shop.
Right, I remember that.
And Colby was there, Matt was there at the reception.
She actually, we had a bunch of bikes and then they got taken before, and then we just had a couple left and she felt like it wasn't worth her time to come out, but I have her phone number, and if we get like a sudden infusion of bikes, she wants me to call her. And so we have set up a connection, but nothing is actually transferred.
So are those reused or recycled? Sorry.
Well, they basically are teaching kids how to repair bikes and giving them bikes. So,
just something, John, about the.
No, sir.
You know, they could leave it at the side of the road with a free sign on it, and it wouldn't cost them any, but to have to spend $10 in addition.
They're pretty successful, so.
Yeah, I know.
They seem to be doing pretty
cost.
Good. If we don't get bikes, we don't get bikes. That's not our issue.
Right.
If you don't get bikes, then maybe try the Hubs thing. Because the Hubs would be free.
Yeah. That's a hard sell for
me. Well, it's just something that we've done before.
Yeah.
And successfully.
Yeah,
so
it
was kind of a...
It was free.
I think they always ask for donations.
No.
I don't think we
they've always asked for
donations. Okay. So now we're just advertising.
Was that okay with people? I just want to make sure.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
With reservation.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Did they take kids' bikes?
Yeah.
They did.
Anything.
Mm-hmm. Toy Exchange, December 12th. We're on tap for that.
They were very successful.
Yeah, the Toy Exchange, Peter, we should probably meet soon,
yeah.
And maybe as a after when we meet in September for the tag sale, because if there's going to be an auction involved, that's going to take a lot more planning, so we should start talking about that.
Well, the auction part I didn't see is huge to start with, but it would, taking last year, so 8 o'clock is the doors open and the cords come in. So they grab it. Meantime, on the stage and with a separate entrance would be a display of the auction stuff that would be going in the auction, and especially if we can get people to donate specifically for the auction,
mm-hmm.
toys
mm-hmm.
specifically.
Mm-hmm.
And then that, so that would be a preview time, and then that could happen at 11, say, 11 to 12 to 1. So that people can come back for that if they've seen something.
Mm-hmm.
They can also do left bids if they like, say, the silent bids,
mm-hmm.
kind of left bids. And I get that, maybe I've forgotten right now, the auctioneer. he would, I'm pretty sure, use some of his stuff
mm-hmm.
as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, and plus some volunteers. But it would give us two shots. It would give us the getting rid of the huge bulk of stuffed and everything else, and then raise some money for better things that, you know, you sort that stuff when it comes in the door, right? Don't you first look at it, whether we accept it or not?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we flag that stuff.
Yeah.
The side.
So it'd be, even at that point, the preview still would be happening prior to the sale, so something that even came in on a Friday night could still be viewed, and you've got those separate entrances.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
For the stage, which
mm-hmm.
is very useful for that.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my thinking on it so far.
Harking back to an earlier, the volunteer issue,
mm-hmm.
do we have a set of criteria for what things we set aside?
For the auction?
For the auction.
Well, we will need one.
Right.
We will
so
need a set of criteria.
Supervisors.
Yeah.
Well, you know,
yep.
For.
Yep. For toys. This is
for anything,
toys.
For anything.
Yeah.
For an auction.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you're talking about the larger issue.
The larger
if
issue.
If we do a...
Yeah.
Okay.
Do we have any criteria, or is it just personal? This looks cool.
Well, it's easier with the toys, because A,
yeah.
it's a toy
yeah.
or not.
Right, right. But I get the quality. we're saving quality stuff.
Yes.
What does that mean?
Yes.
It's always
yeah.
Okay. We have people with smartphones that can look it up, too.
We
can see.
We've
done that with some pieces of art that have come into the Reese Center. Have somebody go on eBay and see if it's for sale on eBay and how much it's sold for.
Okay, next agenda item, new business. Any new business?
I have a piece of new business. I got a call from a woman in Arizona who is, they are beta testing an app that's a sharing app.
Hmm.
And the way it works is you have what you call a tribe, and they're looking at, they want to make it so that businesses and corporations will purchase it, so to speak, for their populations. And for each one of those, they will give one or two free subscriptions to a community group or a nonprofit group. So that's the business model that they're looking at right now. But they want to beta test, and they're looking for groups to test this out to see how it works. Well, not to see how it works, to see, you know, figure out what the glitches might be. And I said that we had a lot of support for reuse and sharing in this area, that it might be worth trying. She said that a tribe is usually no more, I think she said between something like 200 and 500 people. And it would be useful for it to be a cohesive group in some way, whether it's a school or a church or a faith organization. And that this would be free, essentially. It would be a free opportunity. So I wanted to put it out to you. I did not bring my notes with me, but if you want to hear more about it, it sounded very, very cool. Mm-hmm. And so I wanted to see what, if you guys were aware of a organized group that it might work with as a trial in this area.
What comes to my mind is the neighborhood listservs, like our Round Hill neighborhood listserv, mm-hmm. where people do that and other stuff, but we already kind of have a feeling of caring and community, mm-hmm. we do. Mm-hmm. And there are other listservs.
How many are in the Round Hill?
I don't know. David would know. I'll ask him.
Okay.
And he'd be a good person to talk to anyway about that. That
uh-huh.
just occurs to me right now.
Okay, any other ideas? Artist groups?
YMCA?
YMCA?
Or maybe through the art news, the e-news that goes out. You know, the Valley Art, or, well, there's also Valley Art Share.
Mm-hmm.
There's Valley Art Share, which
mm-hmm.
exists.
And the
Valley
Loop?
Arts newsletter.
About the Loop?
The Loop,
that's the group that
yeah.
has those outdoor reuse festivals.
Right. Well, so the point of it is, just to explain a little further, it's to share everyday kind of household
mm-hmm,
objects.
Mm-hmm,
you
mm-hmm.
share your slow cooker. You share your buffet warmer. And
you share it. It's
you,
not,
share
you don't give it away.
You don't give it away.
No.
You have an agreement with a group of people that you will share this,
mm-hmm.
that if
yeah.
you need it, I will share it with you, and you're going to take care of it this and this way.
Mm-hmm.
So.
We do that in co-housing. We already do that.
Yeah. Right.
It happens on time trade.
Mm-hmm.
It does. Okay.
Other new business?
Well, if you have any ideas, please let me know.
Like any neighborhood association.
Yes, right. Like the listservs or whatever other neighborhoods have.
Other new business?
But it's an app.
Next meeting date.
Next meeting date would be... either the 17th or the 24th of September. Now, our event is the 12th, so either one of those is going to be after the event. So it doesn't really
no,
matter.
The 10th would be before.
No, 17th or 24th.
I'm off a week. 17th,
yeah,
17th
or
24th, I see.
We could do either one.
About 17th.
17th makes sense.
Okay.
17th.
Yeah. Okay.
Motion to adjourn.
Motion. Motion. So motioned.
So the reuse committee is officially closed for 8/13/2015.
17.